7 Eastern. We have three new members of the panel. Let's reintroduce the two who remain. Ben Stein, the actor, economist, TV personality, and co-author of the new book, Yes, You Can Supercharge Your Portfolio. That book, there you see its cover. Amy Holmes, the CNN political analyst, remains with us. Joining us as well is Stephanie Miller, nationally syndicated talk radio host. She proudly says she's a liberal. Her father was not. He was William Miller, who was Barry Goldwater's running mate in 1964. Bradley Whitford is the Emmy-winning actor, probably best known for The West Wing, a Democrat backing Hillary Clinton. He has also donated to Barack Obama. And in Miami, our old friend Fran Drescher, the Emmy-nominated actress, New York Times best-selling author, founder of the Cancer Schmancer Movement. The United States State Department has named her special envoy for women's gynecological health issues. She is a Democrat. All right, well, from what you've heard so far from those competing commercials, Stephanie, what's your read on Texas and Ohio?
Well, I think we can all agree that 3 a.m. is when everything bad happens, Larry. It's when you drunk dial people. It's when the wolves that John Kerry wanted to tell the dingoes to eat your babies are going to attack your children. It's, you know, I think people are not going for this fear-mongering anymore, Larry, and I think that's what the polls are showing. You know, we're in a dead heat now in Ohio. Obama has pulled ahead in Texas. I think people are tired of the fear-mongering and the dividing.
You think it's a Hillary mistake?
I do.
Okay. What do you think as a Hillary supporter, Bradley?
Well, you know, I think that these pot shots that they're taking at each other feel sort of archaic, because I think it feels like old-time politics, this kind of fear-mongering. And I think the excitement in the Democratic Party is we have two candidates that have been fantastic candidates. Politics is a zero-sum game. If you have 51%, you're a genius. If you have 49%, you're an idiot. And
so does that make Hillary?
No, I think she's been a fantastic candidate. I think
Brad Whitford says Hillary's an idiot.
I absolutely do not say she's an idiot. I think she's been an incredible candidate. And I think that in Barack Obama, you have a post-baby boom, almost post-racial phenomenon that was very hard to anticipate. But I don't think she's run a particularly bad campaign at all.
Fran Drescher in Miami, what's your read?
Well, I think that basically we're looking at almost the same person running. They agree on almost everything, and there's very, very little difference in the positions that they take. And their voting record since he's become a United States Senator is exactly the same. So I really think, what does it come down to? He's got a great personality. He's a powerful speaker. She's been planning this, thinking about this, and strategizing this for her entire career. And it's really a matter of who seems to be the most ready. And I think that when we talk about who's got experience, I think that her experience is what it's like dealing with really cutthroat opposition and being knocked down and getting back up and fighting the good fight, because she just keeps on going. And and that's really, I think, to her credit. And in a situation like this, in an administration that anybody is going to be coming into, they're going to have to be very tenacious.
Well, you know, Fran, and I agree, Larry. I think that's what people love about the Clintons and about Hillary. Absolutely, they're fighters. But I think the Obama thing is about maybe people are tired of fighting. Maybe people are tired.
Well, you could be you can say that you're tired all you want, but let me tell you something. Whoever comes into this office is going to have a major battle on their hands, because there is just so much going on with global opposition to the United States. So,
true.
We have an email question from Carla in Williamstown, New Jersey. What's the most important quality you look for when deciding to support a presidential candidate, Ben?
I look for a guy who's smart, knows the ropes, has a good ideological base, and above all, loves this country and is proud of this country and wants to keep it. And that's one of the reasons I love McCain, because he has sacrificed so much for this country. But, you know, frankly, I think Mr. Obama loves this country, too, and Mrs. Clinton loves it, too. But I want somebody who's really thoroughly in love with this country.
Amy?
I want someone who wants to cut taxes and kill terrorists. Those are sort of my two bottom lines. I supported Giuliani, like Ben, and I was disappointed that his campaign was such a debacle. So here we are.
What do you want? Brad?
I want somebody who's intelligent. I want somebody who is compassionate, who is looking to build a country where hopefully our schools are as shiny as our missiles.
Stephanie? Oh, wow.
Just a president that can pronounce nuclear. That's all I want, Larry. It's a low bar. Nuclear. It's not that hard. I respond to Barack Obama also because I think he speaks to our better angels. I think, you know, literally, I feel like John McCain's campaign so far is no, we can't. No, we can't. Hope is a drunk throwing up in the alley. It's literally, we're being told not to hope.
Stephanie, actually, John McCain is saying, yes, we can when it comes to Iraq. The surge has been successful, and yes, we can be successful in Iraq.
Success means we can get out, Amy.
And it's Barack Obama who's saying, no, we can't.
If it's so successful, why can't we get out?
When has he ever said that he's against hope? I mean, his whole life has been about the hope of freedom. That's his whole life has been based on hope and perseverance and courage. And no one exemplifies hope.
Barack Obama, I think, is playing to our better angels. If it comes down to it, it's a choice between hope and fear, I'm going to choose hope.
I think that we should not forget that one of the choices here is for this century being about women. And I think that globally, women's rights are eroding. And if we women don't take this opportunity to hire this chubby, middle-aged woman with heavy calves who is willing to fight for us and fight for women's rights and has had a child. She's
you're
raised
one of those
a fine
women that are
daughter.
Posting on Oprah's website that she needs to turn in her vajayjay for not supporting Hillary, aren't you? I know what you're saying, that we all have to support
her. I don't put anybody down for supporting any of the candidates, but I'm just saying that this is our opportunity, and women's rights are eroding globally, and it's really our time to take for a woman to be the leader of the most powerful nation on the planet is going to, in the long run, speak volumes to the world, to our daughters.
I got to get a break, and we'll get Brad's thought. We'll go to our website. By the way, you can go to our website, cnn.com/Larry King. Our latest podcast is Elton John Podcast. Elton John, available to download right now. More with political issues and opinions. We'll pick up with Brad when Larry King Live returns. No, Obama.